Keith Elson at the Trombone Shop Instrument Music back with another instrument review for you. So today I have a vintage Yamaha smallbore tenor. Yes, believe it or not, Yamaha's been around long enough where I think we can consider them vintage. So this particular one is the YSL-651. This was by all records built in the late 70s going into 80s here. So it's a 500 bore small bore tenor. So I'm going to be taking a play on this and then talking a little bit about it afterwards. I'm going to be playing all of this today on a Stork T1. Things about Yamaha, and they do tons of great stuff, but I really wish they had better access to records because they have so many different models that they've created over the years, and it's a lot of times difficult to find information about that. The 651 is kind of one of those out there where there's some mention of it and people talk about it and you see them for sale every so often, but there's not a lot of great information about kind of how it was inspired, what's going on with it. However, it does give us some clues. So we know for sure this was built, and records seem to go back to the late 60s and the 70s. I've run across a few things, maybe even into the early 1980s. But there's a couple things that clue us in as to what the overall inspiration for this was. The first thing that always catches my eye here is the shape of the braces right here. So right here and on the bracing on the hand slide, this is a very, very typical thing we see with old. In fact, a couple of their lines, the old Super format, example comes to mind. Well, that combined with some of the design features here. The nickel silver neck pipe here, nickel silver tunic slide, which is not all that common, all things considered. That combined with the red brass bell here and everything, I think it's very clear, at least to me, that they were very much inspired by the old Super, at least as a starting point with it. And it's so interesting because when I play it, it reminds me a lot of the old Super and a lot of the general playing aspects of it. What I really like about it, it's got a really nice color. There's a softness to the timbre that I think it's really nice. There's a, not an airiness necessarily, but there's some really nice complexity in it too. It doesn't, to me, have a really thick core to it all. It seems it's just a little bit plusher sound all the way around that I really like, especially when you hold back a little bit. I think it's a really nice, it's a mic kind of horn. If you sit on the mic with it, I think it plays really, really nicely for that kind of timbre, especially if you're doing ballads or some section work to it. I think when you push the dynamics a little bit, it does focus in quite a bit. Which we would expect with this kind of setup. It gets quite a bit brighter. You see a bigger shift in the timbre. What I noticed about it, though, is that the some of the overall response is just a little slow. I think even as I'm trying to play faster passages, as I'm trying to do even lip slurs. I feel like there are times where I just have to work a little bit harder to get those partials to lock in. Combined with the fact I think articulations are just a little slower. The upper range, I can get the upper range to play, as you could hear from Joy Spring, but I had to squeeze a little bit, and it lost some of the openness to the sound with it. So I think, again, knowing that, you know, at least to me, it seems like it was inspired by the Super. I think it does a lot of those things well. I think, again, I could see this being a great studio kind of horn where you can sit back on the mic and let it play, you know, let the mixer take some of the, you know, some of the lack of clarity out of it, you know, give it some structure there. Really nice, a really great section horn. I think if you need something, if you spend a lot of time in the upper register, I think you might struggle with it a little bit more. But at the same time, if you're looking for something with some volume, it does, again, I think brighten up really nicely where I think you can get some projection out of it. So it's always interesting to see, you know, horns of this vintage, you know, come through. Again, to see what the evolution has been. I think Yamaha heads, we've seen as much of this with them as with anybody else. They're continually rethinking about what they do. And I mean, I think they have some clear ideas about where things are going now, but it was really interesting to see some of the older instruments, all the different thought processes that were going into it and what they were taking inspiration from. So I hope you enjoyed this review. As always, if you have any questions, thoughts about what you heard, if you have an experience with the 651, leave those comments below. If you like the video, consider giving it a thumbs up. If you haven't already done so, we appreciate you thinking about subscribing to our channel. We're always trying to create new, fresh content for you. And you can check us out on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. So thanks for watching, everybody. ¶¶